Hello everyone, welcome to InfiMinute. In this video clip, we will discuss one problem on star delta transformation. Till now, we have been discussing problems where we have to find equivalent resistance between the two points. In this case, we'll go one step ahead and find something extra. The question says, in the circuit shown in the figure, find the current delivered by a battery using star delta transformation. We have to find out how much current is delivered by the 60 volts battery. So let me mark this current first as current Ix. So I have to find out current Ix because that's the current supplied by 60 volts battery. Now, finding the current supplied by the battery using star delta transformation will be nothing but defining this two nodes as nodes A and B and finding the equivalent resistance between A and B. So if I can find equivalent resistance between A and B, then the current supplied will be nothing but simple Ohm's law. So it's very much similar to the questions that we have solved till now. So let's start everyone and find out what is the equivalent resistance between A and B. If you have a quick look at the given circuit, no two resistors are series or parallel except this 10 ohm and 20 ohms. They can be combined to be in series. But after that, the moment I combine 10 ohm and 20 ohm to be in series, after that, you will see that no two resistors will be in series or parallel. That means we will have to go for star delta transformation. Let us identify a star or a delta and see what kind of transformation we are looking for. So once again, in this case, you may have multiple stars and deltas available. Let us see which star or delta we are going to choose for the transformation. You can see there is a delta available here of three resistors, 15 ohm, 10 ohm and 12 ohm. I can choose this delta and replace this delta with a star. If I do that, the new star will look something like this. Between these three nodes, there will be three resistors connected and this will be the common node or the center node of that particular star network. Once I have done that, this 15, 8 and 12 ohms will be gone. This first resistance of star network will come in series with 4 ohm. This resistance will come in series with 20 ohm. These two resistors will be then in parallel series and further all three resistors in series, and hence I will obtain RAB easily. So the decision of converting this delta to star is perfect. So let's go ahead with that. So I'll now perform two things in one step. I'll club 10 and 20 ohm resistance and I'll also find out the values of resistors in this star network. So let's start from R1. Let me call this as R1, this is R2 and this is R3. R1 will be nothing but 15 into 8 divided by 15 plus 8 plus 12. So that's the value of R1 I'm going to get. R2, because it is connected between 8 and 12 ohms, it is 8 into 12 divided by 15 plus 8 plus 12 again. And finally, R3 will be equal to, now see, R3 is connected between 15 and 12 ohm resistors divided by 15 plus 8 plus 12. Once again, the shape of delta is a square. That is not a problem because this is one straight line which can be taken as a point. And hence, we could convert it into proper star network. So if you calculate, the values will be R1 is 3.429 ohms, R2 is 2.743 and R3 becomes 5.143 ohms. So let's see how the new circuit looks like where we have replaced that particular delta with star. So what I'll do is I'll draw the circuit starting from this 5 ohm resistance. This is 10 ohm as it is. Vertically coming down, you have 4 ohm here. Alright, now I'll add 10 and 20 together. So instead of writing just as 10 ohm, I will make it 30 ohm. So this becomes 30 ohm resistance because these two resistors are added. And now what I'll do is I'll replace that delta with star. So there is one resistor here, one here and one here. This is originally present 5 ohm. R1 is equal to nothing but 3.429 ohms. R2, this was my R2, that is 2.743 ohms. And R3 is nothing but 5.143 ohms. Here we have the battery of 60 volts available, which you may not even draw right now. Right now our aim is to get resistance between these two nodes, which we have defined to be A and B. The next step will be to take these two resistors in series, and 5 and 5.143, they are also in series. So my next form of the circuit would look something like this. So this is what I get. This is my node A and node B. This is 5 ohm resistance, remains as it is, does not go with any other resistors. 4 plus 3.4, so this resistor becomes 7.429. This 30 ohm I've just drawn here as it is. This 30 ohm and this 2.743 will be in series. So this will become 32.743 ohms. And finally, this 5 plus 5, that will give you 10.143 ohm. You can now see that these two resistors are in parallel. So finally, my equivalent circuit in which I will show the battery of 60 volts. Here I did not draw it because it's not required. I will now bring that 60 volts into picture again. And there is only one single resistor now. And this one single resistor will have the value of RAB, where RAB is equal to this 5 ohm that will be in series with 7.429 in parallel with 32.743 and finally added with 10.143. So the total resistance will come out to be 21.198 ohms. And once we know the total resistance RAB, we will now also introduce that current IX again. So current IX will now be equal to simply the Ohm's law. It will be 60 divided by RAB, and that RAB came out to be 21.198. So that gives me the final answer for IX, and IX will be equal to 2.83 amperes. So that's the final answer.